Good morning, children. Sairam. Today, I'm going to take value education subject for you. Today, we will see the very first chapter of value education. So, are you all ready for today's session? Okay, without any delay, we'll start the class. So, as I said, today we are going to see about the chapter number 1 and the title is prayer. The title of the chapter is prayer. So I'll start the lesson. Okay. Dear children, pray to God is very important. Pray to God is very important. To pray is to talk to God. To pray is to talk to God. We are praying to God, isn't it? Praying is nothing but we are talking to God. Okay, so praying to God is very important to all of us. If you pray to God, He will bless you and be with you all the time. If you pray to God, He will bless you and be with you all the time. If you pray to God sincerely, He will bless you and He will be with you at all the time. Whenever you need Him, He will help you and He will bless you and He will be with you all the time. Prayer is a way of saying thanks to God for everything. If your friend is helping you, means you will say thanks to your friend, isn't it? Like that, your way of saying thanks to God is the only thing by doing prayer. Okay, prayer is a way of saying thanks to God for everything. God, without God's help, we cannot do anything, isn't it? So prayer is the only way of saying thanks to God for everything. So pray when you wake up in the morning. So what we have to do? We have to pray to God when we are waking up in the morning. Whenever you find time, you can pray. But when we wake up in the morning, we should pray to God. We should thank God for giving us a new day. Okay. So God lives everywhere. As we all know, God lives everywhere. God lives in all places, isn't it? So God lives everywhere. He knows everything. He knows everything. He is the most powerful. He is the most powerful. God loves you. God loves you. God cares for you. God cares for you. So you can pray to God from anywhere and He will answer. When we are doing prayer to God, so God will answer our prayer, isn't it? So we can pray to God from anywhere, whether it is home, school or temple, wherever, anywhere we can pray and God will answer our prayer. You can ask Him anything and He will give it to you. You can ask anything to Him and He will give it to you. You can call Him by any name and He will surely appear in front of you. For example, if you are worshipping Lord Ganesha means you can call him as Ganesha or Ganpati Papa or any name you can call him. He will surely appear in front of She will surely appear in front of you and he will answer your prayer. Okay. So God cares for you. God loves you. God lives everywhere and he knows everything. He will answer your prayer. To pray early in the morning is a very good habit. We can pray any time to God, but early morning prayer is a very good habit. Pray that everyone everywhere should be happy. You should always pray for everyone, okay? Not for our family, our surroundings, our friend, not for only for our friends. We should pray for our society and for all, everyone. You have to pray for everyone. Pray that everyone everywhere should be happy. We all should be happy, isn't it? So we must pray for everyone. Pray to God to make you strong and clever. Pray to God to make you strong and clever. Recite the following prayers daily. So daily, day-to-day life, we have to follow some prayers to recite to and pray to God. Okay, we will see what are the prayers. So first thing to do prayer, we must get up early in the morning and also go to bed early at night. It is a good habit, isn't it? Get up early in the morning and go to bed early at night. Remember early to bed and early to rise makes a man healthy, wealthy and wise. Remember, early to bed and early to rise makes a man healthy, wealthy and wise. Wise means intelligent. Okay. Take a bath. After you wake up, take a bath. While taking a bath, recite the following prayer. While we taking the bath, we should recite the following prayer. So we will see what is that. I'll recite the sloha for you. Gangai cha Yamune chaiva Gotavari Saraswati. Gangai cha Yamune chaiva Gotavari Saraswati. नर्मदे सिंधु कावेरी जलेस्मिन् सन्निधिं कुरु. नर्मदे सिंधु कावेरी जलेस्मिन् सन्निधिं कुरु. I'll repeat the prayer for you. गंगै च यमुनै चैव गोदावरी सरस्वती. नर्मदे सिंधु कावेरी जलेस्मिन् सन्निधिं कुरु. When we take bath, we should say the prayer. So why we should say the prayer while we take bath? Here I have given explanation. I'll explain to you. Okay. May the holy waters of the rivers Ganga, Yamuna, Gotavari, Narmada, Sindhu and Kaveri come together in this water which I bath. Okay. Now we recite one prayer, isn't it? So we are praying to the holy rivers, that is Ganga, Yamuna, Godavari, Narmada, Sindhu and Kaveri all come together in this water which I am taking bath. Take bath thinking of the water to be holy. Holy means pure, isn't it? So take bath thinking of the water to be holy. So take bath thinking of the water to be holy. After bathing, wear good clothes. After taking bath, we should wear good clothes, isn't it? Comb your hair neatly. Comb your hair neatly. Then sit in front of God calmly. Sit in front of God calmly. When we are sitting in front of God, we are sitting in temple, we should be very calm. We should not make any noise in temple or in a house. Light a lamp. Light a lamp. While lighting the lamp, recite the following prayer. While lighting the lamp, recite the following prayer. I guess we all know this prayer, but I will recite it for you. Subham karoti kalyanam arogyam dana sampataha chatru buddhi vinashaya deepo jyotir namostute. Subham karoti kalyanam arogyam dana sampataha chatru buddhir vinashaya deepa jyotir namostute. When we light the lamp, we should say this prayer, okay? Subham karoti kalyanam arogyam dana sampatha satru buddhi vinashaya deepo jyotir namostute. After saying this prayer, when we are lighting, we will say the prayer, isn't it? So now I'm going to say the explanation for this prayer, okay? I bow down to the flame of the lamp, who is the giver of health and courage, welfare, health, wealth, and the destroyer of the thought of enmity. I bow down to the flame of the lamp. When we are lighting the lamp, we will bow down to the flame of the lamp, isn't it? We will bow down in front of the lamp flame. Okay, who is the giver of help and courage, welfare, health, wealth, and the destroyer of the thought of enmity? After saying this prayer, you can offer flowers and some prasad to God. After finishing prayer, you will offer flowers and some prasad to God. You can offer fruits, flowers, water, leaves, or any other thing to God. You can offer flowers and some prasad to God. After finishing your prayer, you can also offer fruits, flowers, water, leaves, or any other thing to God. God does not see what you are offering to Him. God never sees what you are offering to Him. He only sees your love and devotion towards Him. God sees only your love and devotion towards Him. So you can offer any flowers, fruits, any leaves, or some other prasads to God. He will not see what you are offering to Him. He just wants to see your love and devotion towards Him. Now close your eyes and meditate on Lord Ganesha and recite this prayer. Now, all of you close your eyes and meditate on Lord Ganesha and recite this following prayer. So now I will recite the prayer for you. Mushika Vahana Motaka Hasta Chamara Karna Vilampita Sutra. Mushika Vahana Motaka Hasta Chamara Karna Vilambita Sutra. Vamana Rupa Maheshwara Putra Vigna Vinayaka Pada Namaste. I'll repeat the prayer for you one more time. Mushika Vahana Motaka Hasta. Mushika Vahana Motaka Hasta. Chamara Karna Vilambita Sutra. Chamara Karna Vilambita Sutra. Vamana Rupa Maheshwara Putra. Vamana Rupa Maheshwara Putra. Vigna Vinayaka Pada Namaste. Vigna Vinayaka Pada Namaste. Mushika Vahana Modaka Hasta Chamara Karna Vilambita Sutra. Vamana Rupa Maheshwara Putra. Vigna Vinayaka Pada Namaste. After lighting the lamp, you will say the prayer Subhamukaroti Kalyanam, isn't it? Afterwards, you can offer some flowers to God and close your eyes and meditate to Lord Ganesha and say this prayer Mushika Vahana Modaka Hasta. So I will tell the explanation for this sloka. I bow down to thee who rides the mouse, that is Mushika. I bow down to thee who rides the mouse, who has the sweet meat called Modak. As you all know, Lord Ganesha loves Modak very much, isn't it? Who has the sweet meat called Modak in the cup of the palm. You can see the Lord Ganesha statue, he will have a cup of cup in his palm, isn't it? So in that cup, you can see the Modak. Who has ears like a hand fan. You can see Lord Ganesha's ears is looking like a hand fan, isn't it? Who wears an ornament around the waist. Who is short. Who is the son of Lord Maheshwara, that is Lord Shiva, and who is the remover of all the troubles. As we all know, in all the functions or any celebrations, we will start with Lord Ganesha's prayer or puja, isn't it? So, he will remove all the troubles to us. He will remove all the troubles from us and he will give happiness to us. I'll repeat it for you. I bow down to thee who rides the mouse, who has the sweet meat called Modak in the cup of the palm, who has ears like a hand fan, who wears an ornament around the waist, who is short, who is son of the Lord Shiva or Lord Maheshwara, and who is the remover of all the troubles. So, after finishing Lord Ganesha's prayer, now we are moving to pray the Mother Earth. We are standing on the earth because of the blessings of Mother Earth, isn't it? So, we have to thank the Mother Earth. So, for this, you have to recite this prayer. समुद्र वसने देवी पर्वतस्तन मंडिते विष्णुपत्निर् नमस्तुभ्यं पादस्पर्शं शमस्वमे। समुद्र वसने देवी पर्वतस्तन मंडिते विष्णुपत्निर् नमस्तुभ्यं पादस्पर्शं शमस्वमे। I'll explain the sloka. O goddess, it is earth who is covered by oceans and mountains. As we all know, mountains are nothing but the hills. Oceans is nothing but a big sea. Okay, O goddess, it is O mother earth who is covered by the oceans and mountains. Who is the consort? That is God Lakshmi of Lord Vishnu. Please pardon my touching you with my feet. So we are asking, we are saying, please Mother Earth, who is covered by the oceans and mountains, who is consort of Lord Vishnu, please forgive me of touching you with my feet. Okay. So we are moving to the next one. When we take bath, we will say the prayer to make the water that we are getting bath, which is to be very holy. Okay, after finishing bath, we will light the lamp, isn't it? So when we are lighting the lamp, we will say the prayer Shubham Karoti Kalyanam, isn't it? So next one, after lighting the lamp, we will close our eyes and meditate to Lord Ganesha, and we will recite the prayer Mushika Vakana Motaka Hasta. Afterwards, we will thank our Mother Earth. So after we thank our Mother Earth, we will say the prayer for Tulsi. Now go beside the Tulsi plant in your house. Offer your respects to Goddess Tulsi and recite the following prayer. Tulasi Sri Sakhi Shubhe Papa Harini Punyate Namaste Naradanute Namo Narayana Priye. Tulasi Sri Sakhi सुबे पाप हरणी पुण्यते नमस्ते नारदनुते नमो पारायण नमो नारायण प्रिये। सो आई विल टेल दिस मीनिंग फॉर यू। ओ तुलसी द फ्रेंड ऑफ श्री गॉडेस लक्ष्मी द ऑस्पिशियस वन रिमूवर ऑफ ऑल सिंस एंड गिवर ऑफ मेरिट्स वी बाउ डाउन टू दी। ओ द वन who is worshipped by Narada, we bow down to thee, O the one who is dear to Narayana. After this, you may recite the following morning prayer, that is prayer to Goddess Lakshmi. Sarva Mangala Mangalye Shive Sarvata Sadike सरण्ये त्र्यंबके देवी नारायणी नमोस्तुते। सर्वमंगल मांगल्ये शिवे सर्वार्थ साधिके सरण्ये त्र्यंबके देवी नारायणी नमोस्तुते। ओ द गुडनेस इन ऑल गुड एक्शंस इनकार्नेशन ऑफ प्योरिटी वन हु फुलफिल्स ऑल द डिजायर्स the protector of devotees, the three-eyed one, the beautiful one, the consort of Lord Narayana, that is Lord Vishnu, we bow down to thee. Now we are going to prayer Guru. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, गुरु साक्षात परब्रह्मा तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। गुरु ब्रह्मा गुरु विष्णु गुरु देवो महेश्वर गुरु साक्षात परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। गुरु इज लॉर्ड ब्रह्मा ही इज लॉर्ड विष्णु एंड ही इज ऑल्सो लॉर्ड महेश्वर। गुरु इज द इनकार्नेशन ऑफ द सुप्रीम गॉड। We bow down to that Guru. Guru is Lord Brahma. He is Lord Vishnu. He is also Lord Maheshwara. Guru is the incarnation of the Supreme God. We bow
down to the Guru. Guru is Lord Brahma. He is Lord Vishnu. He is also Lord Maheshwara. It is Lord Shiva. Guru is the incarnation of the Supreme God. We bow down to that Guru. Okay, children, go through the lesson. Just go through the slohas. Try to read the words and just not only to read the slokas. First, you listen to the slokas first. Carefully, after that you just go read the slokas lines and then recite the slokas. Okay children, I'll meet you in the next class. Till then, be safe, stay home, eat healthy food. Thank you.